Well, she's back in the Mall House, our wonderful traveling entertainment. I mean, I don't know what to say about you. All I know is she's in the air all the time. It's Tara. Tara Hitchcock is here, and she's going to talk summer blockbuster movies that we can't wait to see. Hi,
well,
Tara.
Well, the good news is I'm on terra firma. Get it? I'm on solid ground for the day to talk movies with you.
Well, we like terra firma.
Well, we spent a lot of time talking about the 50 Shades of Grey film, which, by the way, is not coming out this summer. They haven't even cast that thing yet. But in your opinion, and I'll tell you what the fans on the big popular Fandango website have been rating their movies at, what is your most anticipated film this summer of 2013? What are you looking forward to, Mal?
Oh, my God. Can you give me some choices? Because, you know, there's a lot that's going on in my head.
The Hangover 3.
Yeah, well, why are we doing Hangover 3? I mean, isn't
you know what?
It...
Fans wanted a reprieve from the second Hangover. You know what? They always decided it was going to be a trilogy, so they are doing Hangover 3. It is the final, the last installment, unless you're like Brett Favre and you decide later to come back again. But this is it. And it looks, I have to say, number two wasn't that great.
No.
This one looks really funny. So I'm actually looking forward to Hangover 3. But that's not really a blockbuster per se.
No, but isn't that like life? I mean, you know, I remember when I was 15 and I had my first hangover. You'd think I would learn, but no, I had to go back for the second one. Finally, I think the third one, I really just said, you know what? This is just not fun.
Well, you know what? We're actually not really fortunate because as you know, Mal, if this film were about three women dealing with a hangover, it would be much less attractive. A drunk woman is.
I know. Why is it that guys can be attractive when they're drunk? I mean, I don't get that.
Not that they're more attractive. No. I just think it's hard to be a drunk woman just on so many levels.
There's nothing attractive about it.
Get away with it as being just typical guy behavior. It really does reflect poorly on us if we're there.
It does. And by the way, I do not think a drunk man is attractive. I just want to say that for the record.
Yeah, I could. Well, Bradley Cooper maybe, but other than that. All right, so here's what fans on Fandango say is the number one film, Iron Man 3.
Oh, you know what? I like Robert Downey Jr.
I do too.
And I think that this movie has been so great for him.
Well, it's been a great franchise for him. He seems to be having a ton of fun doing it, which is really telling because sometimes when you've done these movie junkets with a film that he's involved in, he's just not always in the best mood. I've done the past two Iron Man junkets, and he's just in a chatty, giving, fun, loving mood. So I think he's really enjoyed this. Although the director on this one is not Jon Favreau. He's actually reuniting with the director on that film, Kiss Kiss Bang Bang. His name is Shane Black. So it'll be interesting to see what Shane does with the third installment of Iron Man. But according to fans on Fandango, that is their number one film. Can I tell you actually the surprising film that I'm very excited for? And this ranked number six on Fandango.
Okay, what is it?
Are you a Superman fan?
Well, you know, yes and no. I was a big Christopher Reeve fan.
Sure.
You know, so it's kind of hard for me, but I'm much older than you, so I'm
getting... I have to tell you, you're not that much older than me, and I'm really not... I mean, I love Christopher Reeve. I have not been a huge Superman fan, but I have to say, the trailer for Man of Steel, starring the actor that you and I have all talked about being a possible contender for the lead in 50 Shades of Grey, Henry Cavill, looks awesome. It just looks spectacular. I cannot wait for this installment of Superman to come out. It's called Man of Steel. Man of Steel comes out, I think, on the 14th of June. And you've got a great cast. This thing costs, by the way, they're estimating anywhere between $175 and $225 million.
Wow.
And Michael Shannon, who has been getting a lot of buzz in some of these more independent films, plays General Zod. You've got Russell Crowe in there. You've got Kevin Costner and Diane Lane as the farmers who adopt young Kal-El and raise him as as an American boy. So it's just a great cast, but I have to tell you, you got to get online and just look at the trailer. Whoever did the trailer, it just looks so good.
Well, if you're just joining me, we're talking with Tara Hitchcock and we're talking summer blockbusters, and Superman is on her list here.
Yeah, it really is. Man of Steel. The other one I'm looking forward to, but I'm just a sucker. You know, we talked about Robert Downey Jr. I'm a sucker for Johnny Depp. The Lone Ranger. Gore Verbinski, the director. I've loved every one of his films, even the ones that didn't do so well. in critics' eyes. That comes out a little bit later in the summer, and that stars, of course, Johnny Depp, and it stars Armie Hammer as the Lone Ranger. And, you know, a typical Bruckheimer Disney fashion, a little over the top, a little bit crazy, but just looks like a lot of fun.
Well, now I'm excited about that because I was a huge Lone Ranger fan as a little girl. And my mother, actually, you've met my mom. You know, she was a Western actress in the B-movies, and she was actually in a Lone Ranger. Is that crazy?
I didn't know that about your mom.
Oh, yeah. She was actually in one. And I think that was, she actually played a woman who was, it was a bank robber. So that was really funny.
You know what? We'll have to have a little viewing party. Maybe get your mom out there to share some good stories and see what she thinks of the film. I'd be curious to see what she thinks of the film.
No, I'm excited to see it. But it sounds to me like this film, because Johnny Depp is playing Tonto, that it's really more about Tonto.
I think any movie Johnny Depp is in becomes a movie about Johnny Depp's character.
No, I know. I know. That's so...
Yeah, he could star in The Wolverine with Hugh Jackman and not play The Wolverine, and the film would become about him, not The Wolverine, which is another film, by the way, highly anticipated this summer, where they kind of set it in Japan, but who doesn't love Hugh Jackman and big steel claws, and you've got gold right there.
Hey, now, what's the deal with Hugh Jackman? He's got, like, a stalker?
Yeah, they just had him. In fact, again, an actor that when you interview him is nice, whether you get him at 8 in the morning or 4 p.m. at night. He is just gracious and giving. Here he is dealing with a stalker who apparently recently approached him outside of his gym in New York, approached his wife, only to tell her, oh, by the way, I'm going to marry your husband one day, approached his kid at their school. So I think she is now dealing with a lot of illegal issues. But, of course, he's bombarded by the media outside of his gym to answer questions about it. And in gracious, non-Alec Baldwin form, just stands there and answers whatever questions he's given. He's just so gracious when dealing with this stuff. And, yeah, unfortunately, that's just a, you know, I think most celebrities probably have to deal with a stalker. It's just a matter of what level of of psychoness you have to deal with. And in this case, this woman seems pretty disturbed. But every comment he's made about her is, you just hope she gets the help she needs.
So he's been so nice. I know. Charlie and I met him in a Broadway Cares event in New York City. And he was just wonderful.
Yeah, so nice.
Oh, he's, I know.
And one of those guys that somehow has a way of making you feel like, honestly, at the end of the interview, if you just asked him if he'd like to be friends, he would say yes and maybe Facebook you later. Even if he's full of crap.
Now you've got all my listeners are going, oh, that's so great. You know,
they're going, I know. So and he's actually pretty approachable. I don't want to
we don't need
that away,
we don't need to be giving
him. I'm sure he'd be just as nice to you as he would be to somebody interviewing him for TV.
Terry Hitchcock's here. She's in the Mall House. We're talking summer movies. And we were just talking about, stalkers. And by the way, please don't go up to Hugh Jackman and ask him to be your friend in Facebook, and because then Tara's going to get in trouble.
Yeah, and at least don't mention our names if you do it.
Yes.
We didn't recommend it.
No.
Okay, what are the odds of two films within a few months of each other coming out that are both about the White House under siege and our country's in big trouble?
You know, are these two different directors, all different casts?
Two different directors. Olympus Has Fallen just came out not too long ago with Gerard Butler. Just saw the trailer, and it actually may have been while I was watching Olympus Has Fallen, for White House Down.
Wow.
Same kind of premise, different actors, different people who take over the White House. The good news for all of you who did not see Olympus Has Fallen is Channing Tatum is in this next one with Jamie Foxx. And again, talking about the Man of Steel trailer looking fantastic, Roland Emmerich, the guy behind Independence Day and some of those big, Independence Day blockbusters, is behind this one, and it just looks great. And I'm saying this literally having just seen Olympus Has Fallen, which in my opinion was very predictable.
Sure.
But I'm excited to see White House Down, starring Jamie Foxx
Now,
as the president, and Channing Tatum. I could watch that guy all day.
Well, and Jamie Foxx is a great guy. I met him backstage one time at the Grammys. Nice, nice guy. Wanted to talk football with Charlie.
Oh, yeah. That's just it. Very down to earth. The film looks great. And, you know, it's been getting a little bit slack because Roland Emmerich and that whole crew that he uses, again, over the top, special effects, somewhat predictable. But as Channing said in a recent interview, you know what? I want to be entertained and chew popcorn on Independence Day weekend. And that's exactly what you'll get if you go see White House Down. That's the big film that opens on July 3rd, which is traditionally a huge weekend for movies, usually starring Will Smith. He's in one, actually, I think that week or the following week, starring his son, directed by M. Night Shyamalan, called After Earth. He comes out in one a little bit later. I think actually, you know what? I take that back. That film comes out in June.
Well, okay, these are all like big blockbusters and all of this. Do we have any love in any of this? Is there a love story for me this summer? Because you know I am so into romance.
You know what? Well, define love. I think Monsters University, the story about the two main characters and how they overcame their differences while in college, to me, that's a movie about love.
Well,
but you might be thinking of more of the romance.
I am.
Whereas I see just, you know, two guys overcoming the odds. Monsters University comes out June 22nd or 21st. Billy Crystal, John Goodman are back as Mike and Sully.
Aww.
And to me, that's a film about love, just like the one you're looking for.
Well, see, I love love. You know I love love.
I know. You know what? I got to tell you, Maul, that's a great question, because in terms of just a great romance,
mm-hmm.
I don't know if there really is one. I mean, you got The Hangover 3. That's
right.
The Wolfpack. You do have... you know, this could be your little sleeper.
Okay.
Ethan Hawke and Julie Delpy, of course, they became very well known in Before Sunrise and Before
yeah.
Sunset. Now they've got Before Midnight. Richard Linklater directs that one. That's coming out the end of May. Maybe that's your film about love.
Well, I think that every summer needs a love story.
Fast
you know?
And Furious 6, will that count?
No.
Bullock, Melissa McCarthy, I'm looking forward to that.
All right, you know what? I have to tell you, I am looking forward to that. Because number one, I'm a big Sandra Bullock lover. Love,
yep,
love,
too.
Love her.
So there's your love. It's called The Heat. That could be love, heat.
Well, I don't think that's what I was looking for, but I am looking forward to the two of them together. I think that's going to be fun.
Too. I think it'll be great, too. The Internship, again, another buddy, Owen Wilson, Vince Vaughn, back together again. That could be about love.
Well, it sounds like we're going to be on the edge of our seats this summer, and we're going to be laughing a lot, but the love department is probably going to be lacking, so what they're going to have to do is make sure they have a glass of wine and curl up while they watch the movie so they can be romantic. Tara Hitchcock, thank you for joining us.
Thanks, Ma. Yeah, you've got a lot of action, a lot of space, some zombie stuff. That's just be entertained, get your popcorn, and maybe deal with love a little bit later on television, perhaps.
All right, well, come back and talk love movies for me next time, okay?
I will. We'll talk about our favorite.
All right, honey. Thanks so much.